A very happy morning to my dear students. Welcome to Science Online class. Children, I hope you are all fine and you must have bought your books and notebooks by now. Except for very few children, you can buy it as soon as possible. And from today onwards, you are going to write in your classwork notebook. So don't miss to watch the video till the end so that you get the instructions of how you must write the classwork notebook. So children, we are going to revise chapter 1 in biological science, biology. The science of life. So why do we call biology as the science of life? Because biology is derived from two words, bios and logy. So the word bios means life and the logy, the word logy means study of. So in biology is a branch of science which deals with the study of living organism or living beings. So that's why we call biology as the science of life. So in biology, we'll be learning about the various aspects related to living organisms. And you'll also learn about the interaction of living organism with the surroundings. So you'll be learning about the body system, the organ systems, about plant life, animal life, and the classification of plants and animals. So everything will be dealt in biology. And in today's class, we are going to discuss about few characteristics of living beings. So you must know that all living beings are made up of cells. So this is the main important, the vital character of a living being. So without cell, we cannot exist. Cell is the structural and the functional unit of all living organism. We can say cell as the basic unit of life. So why do we call cell as the basic unit of life is because you just imagine a building. A building is made up of many bricks. So we put cement and we keep the bricks together to create a building. Similarly, our body is created by number of cells combined together. So that's why all living beings are made up of cell, but the non-living beings, they are not made up of cells. And some living beings are made up of trillions and million number of cells. For example, human being, we are made up of trillion number of cells combined together so that we are able to survive. For example, a plant or you can say an animal, they are also made up of millions and many number of cells. So we all come under a category called as multicellular organism. So multicellular means we are made up of many number. Multi is many. So we are made up of many number of cells. That's why we are called as multicellular organism. Whereas some organisms like bacteria, they are made up of only one number, only a single cell. So they are called as unicellular organism. So multicellular organisms are made up of many number of cells, whereas unicellular organisms are made up of only one number, a single number of cell. And this is the most important property of a living being. And next, this living being can grow. So when you were a child, you were very small, but now you have grown up. So this growth is possible only in a living being, whereas in non-living being, growth doesn't happen. So this is how we can differentiate a living being as well as a non-living being. Can you see a table or a pen or this marker growing? No, it is not possible. Only a living being can grow. The next characteristic is living beings need food. We need food to survive because food gives us energy. Food is needed for our growth. Food is needed to maintain the vital activities, the important activities which is going on in our body. So that's why we need food to survive. But non-living thing, does it eat anything? Does it need any food? No. So living beings need food, whereas non-living being, they doesn't need food. And living beings, they fall under two categories like autotrophs and heterotrophs. So what are autotrophs? So autotrophs mean the organism that produce their own food, they are called as autotrophs. For example, plants produce their own food. Okay, so they are called as autotrophs. So which part of the plant produce food? As children, you are right, the leaves in the plant produce the food. They are called the kitchen for the plants because the food is produced in the leaf through the process called as photosynthesis. And another group of organism is heterotrophs. So what are heterotrophs? Heterotrophs are organism. They depend on other organism for the food. For example, we depend on plants for our food. We eat chicken, then we depend on animals for food. So human beings depend on plant as well as animals for their food. So we fall under the category heterotrophs. So next characteristic is living beings respire. So living beings respire. Respire means breathe. So we all breathe. We take in oxygen. We give out carbon dioxide. So this process is very important for every living being. So when we don't breathe, we say we are dead. So this characteristic respiration, it differentiates a living being from a non-living being. So we take in oxygen. How does this oxygen help us? The oxygen is helpful in breaking down the food, and finally the energy and glucose is produced through that process. So the respiration is a very important process, a very important life process that happens in our body. And the next characteristic is living means throw out waste. So we all give out waste in many forms, like we sweat, we give out waste, we give out carbon dioxide during respiration, we give out urine, we excrete urine and feces. So these are the forms through which the waste is excreted from our body. So excretion is the process by which the waste product from our body. So many life processes happen in our body, like respiration, digestion. So from all this process, some waste is given out, and this waste is taken out from our body through this process called as excretion, which happens only in the living being. And the next thing is living beings move. We can move from one place to another. So I am able to move from this side of the boat to this side. So this happens, this is possible only with the in living being. So can this marker move if I drop it down? Can it move from here to there? No, it is not possible, because living being alone can move. And this process of movement from one place to another is called as locomotion. So what is locomotion? The process of movement from one place to another, it is called as locomotion. And even plants move. Have you seen the plants? Usually they turn to the direction from where the sunlight comes. So this is how the plants move. And children, the next thing is the living beings reproduce. Yes, reproduction happens in living beings. We give birth to younger ones. So this important process happens only in the living beings. So reproduction is the process by which the younger ones are produced. So human being, we reproduce to the younger one of same kind. Animals, some animals, they lay eggs. Other animals give birth to the younger ones. Plants also give seeds from which new plants grow. So this is how reproduction happens in the living beings. The next is they follow a life cycle. So all living beings, we follow a definite life cycle. So when you see, when you first you are born, then you grow, then you become adult, you reproduce, you become old, and finally you die. So these are the various stages in our life. So all this process, we pass through all the stages. Okay, so this is what we call as a life cycle. So the time period from a birth to death is called as lifespan. For example, the average lifespan of an average human being is, we can say, 70 years. But nowadays, it's like only 50 or 60 years. In animal, each animal has its own lifespan. And another important point which I left out here is living beings respond to stimuli. So if when someone give me they beat me with a scale, I suddenly immediately react. Or when I put my hands into a pot of hot water, I immediately withdraw my hand. How does it happen? It is because our nervous system help in responding to the stimuli. So the process by which we respond to the stimuli, it is called as sensitivity. It is called sensitivity. We are sensitive to certain things. So living beings respond to stimuli. So children, now you can turn your books to page number 1, Biology, the Science of Life. So we are going to go through the entire lesson, and we'll be learning few important terms in the less terminologies in your lesson. And also watch the video till the end so that you will know the instructions to be followed while writing your biology classwork. Dear students, you can turn your biology book to page number 1. Chapter 1, Biology, the Science of Life. The very first line says us that biology is the science of life, which means biology is the branch of science that deals with the study of life or the living beings. And biologists are the people who study biology. Okay, they are experts in biology who do research in biology. So people who study biology, they are called as biologists, and they are concerned with the various aspect of life. So they study about the different form of life. They study about plant life, animal life, and they also deal with the interaction between a living being and the surrounding, which means they study about the relationship of a living being, a relationship of an organism with its environment or surrounding. So in this chapter we'll be discussing lot of things related to living beings. So first we are going to distinguish living being from a non-living thing. So I have already given you a brief introduction of the characteristics of living being. So now we are going to read the characteristics line by line, and we will be understanding it more in detail. So the very first characteristic is living beings are made up of cells. Yes, all living beings are made up of cell. And we know that cell is the smallest thing that in our body that has life. And a cell can exist. It can exist on its own. And I said you that the cells are the structural and the functional unit of every living organism. And some living beings are made up of a single cell, and some living beings are made up of many number of cells. So the unicellular organism, the word uni means single, cellular means cell, organism means living being. So unicellular organisms are organisms made up of a single cell. The common example is bacteria. And some organism are made up of many number of cells, maybe a million or trillion number of cells, and these organisms are called as multicellular organism. The common examples are human being, birds, animals and trees. The cells are usually very small and you cannot see a cell through your naked eyes. So we use an instrument called as microscope. Microscope is an instrument we use to look at the cell, because things appear large when you see through a microscope. So the cells are usually seen under microscope, and you'll be learning in detail about microscope in your next lesson. Children, take your pencil and underline all the important points in this two paragraphs. All living beings are made up of cells. You underline what is unicellular organism and what is called multicellular organism. And move on to the next paragraph. You can underline that microscope are instrument that is used to make things appear large. From last third line, you can underline those lines. And we'll move on to the next characteristic. So living beings grow. So only living being can grow, and non-living beings, they do not. Non-living things do not grow, though some seem to, which means some appear as if it is growing, but it is not actually the growth. So for example, when you suspend sugar crystals in a sugar solution, so you can look at this picture. They have suspended sugar crystals through a tie in a sugar solution. So after some time, when you look at the jar, you can see the sugar crystals get deposited on the tie. Okay, so the sugar crystals grow as more sugar is deposited from outside.
And when you blow a balloon, the balloon appears to grow in size when we blow air into it. But when you release the air out of the balloon shrink back to the original size. So this also seems to be growth, but this growth is different from that of a living being, because in living being grows from inside as the cells grow and multiply. So there is a process called cell division which happens in every living organism, through which the cells divide and multiply and finally growth occurs. But in non-living thing it is not so. Non-living things sometimes appear as if it is growing. It is because something is added from outside, as we saw in the experiment of the sugar crystals. So students, the second characteristic is living beings grow. So you can underline few lines there. Underline the first line: only living beings grow, non-living things do not grow, though some seem to. And turn to the next page, page number 2, you can underline the first two lines. A living being, on the other hand, grow from inside as its cell grows and multiply. So coming to the third characteristic, living beings need food. So we all need food to survive. Living beings cannot survive without food. So we use the energy derived from the food to perform various function, which means, so from the food we get energy. We use this energy to perform, to do various functions in our body. So we also need food for our growth and maintenance of our body. So that is said in your third line. So children, are you all following with your pencil? Okay, move on to the third line. They also need food to grow and maintain their body. So for growth and maintenance of body we need food, and non-living things do not need food. Move on to the next paragraph. Green plants are different from other living beings in matter of getting the food. Okay, green plants are different from other living beings. So now we'll see how it is different, because green plants, they manufacture their own food using solar energy. Solar energy is your sunlight, water and carbon dioxide. So green plants, they prepare food by using sunlight, water, the root absorbs water from the soil, and carbon dioxide, the leaves take in carbon dioxide. So children, we have seen that leaves has got minute pores through which gas exchange happens, which means the carbon dioxide enter the body of the plant and oxygen is given out through these small pores, and these pores are called as stomata. Okay, so the plant prepare food by using sunlight and water, which is absorbed by the roots, and carbon dioxide which get into the plant through the leaves. And this is why the plants are called as, the green plants are called as autotrophs. So auto means self and trophos means feeder in Greek. So the organism that prepare their own food, they are called as autotroph. And organism that depend on other organism for food, they are called as heterotrophs. Heteros means other in Greek, and all animals are heterotrophs. So children, you can underline what is autotroph. So plant manufacture, the third line. Second paragraph, third line. They manufacture their food using solar energy, water, carbon dioxide. So this is why they are called autotrophs. And you can underline the last two line. Heteros means other in Greek. Organism that depend on other for food are called heterotrophs. So these are some important terminologies in this paragraph. Next, moving on to the next paragraph, living beings respire. So living beings need oxygen. They take it from the air or water. And inside the body, oxygen is used to break down the food and release the energy which is stored in it. So oxygen is mainly used for breaking down of the food, and it helps in producing the energy. So when food is broken down, carbon dioxide and water are produce. So what happens in respiration? We take in oxygen, and this oxygen is used by our body in breaking down the food. So once the food is broken down, it releases carbon dioxide and water. So this entire process is called respiration. So you can underline with your pencil the entire process of taking in oxygen, breaking down food and releasing carbon dioxide and water is called respiration. And only living beings respire. Non-living beings, they do not respire. So moving on to the next characteristics, living beings throw out waste. So children, are you all with me? We have seen three characteristics. Living beings are made up of cells, living beings grow, living beings need food, and living beings respire. We have seen four characteristics. So now we are moving on to the fifth characteristic. Living beings throw out waste, which means living beings give out waste, or else they excrete. The life processes that go on inside the body produce waste such as carbon dioxide and water. So many life processes like respiration, digestion, many process happens in our body. So they produce waste. Each of these processes produce some waste such as carbon dioxide and water. So we throw out the waste from the body in the form of sweat, urine and feces. Okay, you can underline this line. We throw out the waste from the body in the form of --, sweat, urine and feces. The process of throwing out waste from the body is called excretion. You can underline this also. Excretion too is the characteristic that only living beings possess. So the process of throwing out the waste, giving out the waste from the body is called as excretion. So how do plants get rid of waste? How do they give out the waste? The plants give out the waste gases through minute. Minute means very small pores. Pores are holes. I told you stomata. So the gases are given out through minute pores which are present in their leaves, but they cannot give out, they cannot throw out solid waste. So they store the solid waste in some part of the body such as the leaves and the bark. Okay, the tree bark stores the solid waste of the plant. So when they shed their leaves and bark, so during some seasons the leaves will shed off, they'll fall down, and the bark will also shed off. So the waste accumulated in these parts, they get expelled, they get thrown out. So this is how plants get rid of waste. So you must know what is excretion, and you must know how does the plant get rid of waste. So next, moving on to the next paragraph, living beings respond to stimuli. So when someone flashes a bright light in front of your eyes, you close them immediately. Or when your hand touches a hot object accidentally, you withdraw your hands immediately. So these actions are responses to the stimuli. So what is stimuli? Stimuli are things that produce a response or a reaction. So you can underline this line. Stimuli are things that produce a response or a reaction. And the ability to respond to a stimuli is called sensitivity. So sensitivity means you are able to respond. You are able to respond immediately to a stimuli. So what is stimuli? Stimuli are things that produce the response. And what is sensitivity? The ability to respond to a stimuli is called sensitivity. Kids, do all living beings respond to stimuli? Yes, have you noticed? Yes, we human beings, we respond to stimuli. Even plants respond to stimuli. They respond to touch, light, temperature and so on. So when you take an example of a sensitive plant is the touch me not plant. So we say totta chinigi in Tamil, no? So the leaves of a sensitive plant, it close when you touch them. And many flowers like China rose, lotus, they open in the morning because they are sensitive to the light. So open in the morning and they close in the evening. And leaves of gulmohar also behave in the same way. Okay, they all open in the morning and they close in the evening because they are all sensitive to stimuli like touch, light and temperature. So children, what is sensitivity? The ability to respond to a stimuli is called sensitivity. What is stimuli then? Stimuli are things that produce a response or a reaction. Next, let's move on to the next characteristic. Living beings move. So animals can move different parts of their body. They can also move from place to place. So moving from one place to another place is called locomotion. You can underline this. Moving from place to place is called locomotion. Although plants do not show locomotion, can a plant move from one place to another? No, they cannot move. But different parts of a plant show movement. But the plants can move their parts. Okay, now let's see how do plants show locomotion. The weak stems of some climbers twine around the supports. So you would have seen the climber plants usually twine around a big tree. And the stems of some plants, they bend towards, they turn towards the direction from where light comes. And the leaves and flowers open and close based on sunlight falling on them. Okay, the flowers open during morning, they close during the evening. So all these are some movements shown by plants. And even some non-living things like vehicles, okay, they also show movement. So you would have seen cars and bikes and cycle moving from one place to movement, but one place to another. But the difference is the non-living things, they can only move by using some source of energy outside them, which means the vehicles move only with the help of oil, petrol and diesel. So without petrol or diesel, which gives energy, they do not move from one place to another. So non-living things can move, but they use some source of energy outside them. So one activity you can do is you can plant a seedling. Okay, you can use a seedling of pea or a bean or gram in a pot. And you can cut a window on one side of a cardboard box as it is shown in this figure, in figure 1.7. And you can cover the plant with box in such a way that sunlight enters the box only through one the window. So you have to make a window in the cardboard box and you have to make sure that sunlight enters through the window. And water the plant regularly, and in a day or two you can see the stem will bend towards the light. So when you observe for 2 or 3 days, you can see the stem moving towards the window, so towards the light. So you can do this small activity at your home during this weekend maybe, and you can take a photo and you can post in your WhatsApp. So we'll do this activity during this weekend. So next, living beings reproduce. Living beings reproduce or produce their own kind. So reproduction means producing our own kind. So you can underline this. Living beings produce their own kind. Some animals lay eggs and other give birth to young ones that look like them. And many plants also produce seeds from which seedlings. Seedlings are new plants, small plants, that young plants that come out. Some plants also give out new plants from their roots, stems or leaves. So some plants you would have seen, they will come out from the, they will rise from the roots or from the leaves. So this is how the plants show reproduction. Next, we'll move on to the next last characteristic. Living beings follow a life cycle. All living beings follow a definite life cycle which start with birth. So after birth, growth, reproduction, aging and death. So the time between the birth and death of an organism is called lifespan. You can underline this. And it varies from organism to organism. The average lifespan of the bacteria is just 20 minutes. While a human being's lifespan is 75 to 80 years. So students, these are the characteristics of living beings which differentiate them from the non-living things. The first one is living beings are made up of cells and they grow, they need food, they respire, they give out waste, they respond to stimuli, they can move from one place to another, they reproduce and they follow a definite life cycle. turn to page number 4. You can go through the points to remember in this page. And also you come to page number 5 now. You can complete exercise A, B and C on your own. And exercise D, I will give you the answers in WhatsApp, which you can copy in your classwork. Children, listen carefully. I'm going to give you instruction regarding your classwork. So you'll be given 3 192 pages, one side ruled notebook. So you can allot one notebook for your physics and one notebook for your chemistry and one notebook for your biological science. So children, you can take your biology classwork first. So you can take your index page. In index page, you can fill the first name, subject, section and come down to the index column. In serial number, you can write 1 as usual and you write today's date 23/7/2020. Then you can write the title of the lesson, the name of the lesson, Biology, the Science of Life. So turn on to this first page, leave the first page and start from the next page. So you can first write chapter 1 in the first line. Then you can write the name of the chapter, Biology, the Science of Life, in the second line. After which you can draw a double margin as how you do in your composition notebook. And you can start with the first Roman letter. Children, I have sent you the notes in your WhatsApp. So you can copy down the notes under first Roman letter and second Roman letter in your classwork. No need to copy any objective type questions that fill in the blanks, choose and true or false. Okay, just you can mark the answers in your book itself. Only the D and E, that is answer the following and explain in brief, you will be writing in your classwork notebook. So children, write neatly and I will be giving you a few diagrams to draw in your notebook. The diagrams can be drawn in the unruled side of your notebook. Students, if you have any doubt regarding your classwork, you can contact me. I'll help you out. Children, you can make note of today's assignment. Thank you, children. Have a nice day.